question was posed to me in a comment yesterday regarding Chivas Regal 18 and Dewar's 21. This Dewar's 21 has been open a lot longer than the Chivas 18, and it's a much smaller bottle. It's half a bottle. They don't come in full-size bottles, making it, I guess, more affordable to try it, but then you don't have as much to enjoy. And the Chivas 18, well, I enjoy Chivas 18 a lot. I have them here poured right in front of me. I'm going to go give them a nose. Chivas 18 first. Oh, that is nice. There's some caramel, there's some vanilla, there's some spice. It doesn't quite come across like a blended malt, and it doesn't quite come across like a single malt. You know it's a blend. It's bottled at 40% alcohol by volume. But it's still quite malty. They've done a nice job on this one. This is one of my favorite blends in existence. Others would include things like Cutty Sark Prohibition and perhaps Cato's or Cato's, depending on, yeah. Let us move to the nose of the Dewar's 21. This video is in response to a comment. Oh, the Dewar's 21 has a lot of butterscotch. In comparison, a lot of butterscotch. Oh, wow. This is getting better as I come back to it. This one also, I believe, is bottled at 40%. 46%. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Once again, this has some malt in it. You get the maltiness, and that butterscotch note is really prevalent. I didn't notice that so much before. I believe this one has had the opportunity to open up. Back to the Chivas. This is sweeter. But it's not a cloyingly sweet. This one is more fruity, I would say, than the Dewar's. I'm getting some melons. And a maltiness. Back to the Dewar's. Oh yeah, beautiful butterscotch note. Not quite as fruity. Of course, I knew the answer to the question that was posed already. The question was, which of these two is more grainy? They're not very grainy at all. And that's what I was going to type in response yesterday. As they've had enough time in the wood for the complexity from the wood to come in and coat over any graininess that you would get, at least on the nose. These are fully matured whiskeys. I would expect to get more graininess on a whiskey that is not quite fully matured. Try Johnny Walker Red, for example. Try Chivas Regal 12. No, not so much. Actually, that one isn't. That one's just very nice. Okay, I'm going to try the Dewar's 21 on the palate. It's rich. It's fruity. It's complex. This is more delicious than I remember it. There's a bit of a spicy finish on the tip of my tongue, particularly. Now I will go to the weaker Chivas. Why did I do it that way? I don't know. The finish for the Dewar's 21 is lasting. Like I said, it's not very grainy due to its age and maturation. Like I said, you can expect it to be grainier if it's younger, like a Johnny Walker Red, or for example, a Cutty Sark, a regular Cutty Sark, bottled at 40% alcohol by volume. You can also go for like a Dewar's white label. Although this has a white label, it's 21 years old. It's got that age statement there. Whereas the regular Dewar's white label would be more grainy than this one. Chivas 18. Oh, I'm getting caramel. I'm getting chocolate. I'm getting some fruitiness. I'm getting a spice. The spice is milder than that of the Dewar's 21. But yeah, there's chocolate in here too. This is nice. Both of these are nice. Oh, there's that butterscotch note again. Oh my goodness, that is nice. The Dewar's now is coming across as a little bit sweeter, probably because I don't know why, because the Chivas is just yummy. Okay. How about this? You can tell that it's not, that either of them is not a blended malt or a single malt. You can tell. You know it's a blend. You know it's a blended Scotch whiskey. You know it's got some grain grain spirits in there. But both of them are so nicely blended and fully matured that they're not really grainy at all. Although if I was to hazard a guess as to which one would have a more grainy character, even though they're not really grainy, the grain doesn't jump out at you. You can tell, I've probably said this already, you can tell that they are blended by virtue of them being gentler. Being gentler than a single malt or a blended malt. And that's what blended Scotch whiskey was all about. To make it more drinkable than what would come straight out of the line arm of that would come out of a single malt. So this is why they this is why they blend Scotch whiskey. That's why they blend the malts that give the flavor with the grains that give the gentleness, making the whole more drinkable than either straight grain or straight rye, straight grain or straight malt. A grainy whiskey would show a lack of refinement. Oh, I love that butterscotch note of the 21 Dewars. Love it, love it, love it. I might try and chase down a second bottle of this. It's very nice. In conclusion, I would have to say that neither of them is particularly grainy. Although you can tell that there is a grainy element to them, but that would be much more... I know, I'm repeating myself, okay? I'm repeating myself. I like them both equally, and they are equally grainy or not grainy. How's that for an answer?
Food quig.
Food quig.
Food quig.
Food quig.
Food quig.
Yeah.